Yes, dear students, in our last video you have studied about gravitational potential energy and gravitational potential. In this video we will study about escape energy, escape velocity and orbital velocity. Now you know that gravitational potential energy is given by this formula minus g mem upon r. If we have to find out potential energy on the surface of earth, in place of r we write re. Re stands for the radius of earth. This is the potential energy of an object of mass m which is on the surface of earth. Now if in place of r we write infinity, that means what? We want to find the potential energy at infinity. So minus g m upon infinity will become how much? It will become zero. So the potential energy at infinity is zero. So the surface of earth is this much, at infinity is zero. Now if this object which is on the surface of earth is given energy equal to this much, it is given g m e upon r e. Again, understand this point. The object which is on the surface of earth has got this much energy. If this object is given energy plus positive part, g m e upon r e, this total energy will become how much? It will become zero. And you know that potential energy at infinity is zero. So by getting this much energy, this object which is on the surface of earth will escape to infinity. Therefore, this energy is called escape energy. Clear? This is the formula for escape energy. So this is the formula for escape energy. And the minimum velocity which is given to the object to escape to infinity, that is called escape velocity. The minimum energy required for the object to escape to infinity is called escape velocity. So if V is escape velocity, then the kinetic energy must be equal to the escape energy. We get this half mve square. This is the energy given to the object, and this object which is on the surface of earth, and if this energy equals to escape energy, so this object will escape to infinity. Therefore this velocity which is given is called escape velocity. This is equal to g mem upon re. On solving it, you can find out, yeah, you can see this is m cancel, so this is gme upon 2 gme upon re. So this is the formula for escape velocity. Now in terms of acceleration to gravity, you know small g, this is gme upon re square. Find out the value of gme, this is gre square, put it here. So this will be v is equal to under root 2gre. When you keep the value of g and r radius of earth, it comes out to be approximately 11.2 kilometer per second. So this is the approximate value of escape velocity. If an object is given velocity 11.2 km per second, it will escape to infinity. That means it will not return back to the surface of earth. So this velocity is called escape velocity. Our next topic is orbital speed and period of revolution of satellite. Now as we know that when an object is moving in a circular orbit, it requires a force which is known as centripetal force. Similarly, when a satellite is revolving around earth, its path is circular, so it requires a force, centripetal force. So the necessary centripetal force is provided to the satellite by the gravitational force of attraction between the satellite and the earth. As it is moving in circular orbit, it requires a force known as centripetal force. So the necessary centripetal force is provided to it by the gravitational force of attraction between the satellite and the earth. Now if the distance of satellite from the surface center of earth is small r, then the centripetal force, and if it supports orbital speed is v0, centripetal force is mv0 square upon r. So this is the centripetal force which it requires, and this it gets from the gravitational force of attraction, and that is equal to g mem upon r square. The necessary central force is provided to it by the gravitational force or attraction between the satellite and the earth, where BO is called its orbital speed. On solving, you get V0 is equal to under root GME upon R. Now, if the height of the satellite is given from the surface of Earth, then your formula becomes under root GME upon RE plus H. This R is the distance from the center of Earth. If height is given, so we write small r as RE plus H, RE is the radius of Earth. Now in terms of small g, we know small g is equal to GME upon RE square. So GME becomes GRE square. For the value here, so this is under root GRE square upon RE plus H. Now for the satellite which is orbiting very near to the surface of Earth, that means H is negligible in terms of RE. In that case, negate H, the formula becomes VO is equal to under root GRE square upon RE. That means when the satellite is orbiting near to the surface of Earth, H is negligible. With negate H, it is under root GRE. This is the formula for orbital speed of a satellite which is orbiting around the surface, around the Earth. Now if T is the period of revolution of satellite, T capital T, then T is equal to total distance travelled upon orbital velocity. In one complete revolution, total distance travelled is 2 pi r. It's 2 pi r upon its orbital speed VO. Well, what is T? This is the period of revolution of satellite around Earth. The total distance in one revolution 2 pi r upon the orbital velocity VO. Now, just now you have seen what is VO. VO is under root GME upon R. On putting this value here, we get this is 2 pi r upon VO. This becomes R upon GME. This you can write as 2 pi under root R cube upon GME. Now if they have given this height for the surface of Earth, this small r becomes 2 pi this T and RE plus H whole cube upon GME. And in terms of small g, we can replace GME by GRE square. This becomes T is equal to 2 pi RE plus H whole cube upon GRE square. These are different formulas. Now if the satellite is orbiting near to the surface of Earth, we just neglect G, H from here. If the satellite is orbiting near to the surface of Earth, and this you can get right as T is equal to 2 pi RE cube, just negating H, this is 2 pi RE cube upon GME. Similarly here, negate H, this will be RE cube upon RE square. So you can, this becomes T is equal to 2 pi RE upon G. So these are different formulas for period of revolution of satellite around the surface of Earth.